The dog days of summer in Tennessee, and we're here to talk about everybody's favorite summer annual weed, goosegrass. All right, so we've got a bit of a unique research site here today. So this is a sand-based site. We've got Bermudagrass in half of the plot, and then we've got weeds in the other half of the plot. And this was done by design, because our idea was, well, let's look at some treatments, and we want to know, is the treatment safe to the turf that we're trying to maintain, and does it control the weeds that we're trying to remove from that turf? So in this trial, you know, our target weed here is goosegrass, and we have Bermudagrass as our desirable turf. So this is our non-treated control plot. This received no herbicide. You can see in the Bermudagrass portion of that plot, we have our Bermudagrass and other weeds. We've got some crabgrass in there. We have some goosegrass in there, maybe even a little bit of Kalinga in spots. And then here in our weed portion of the plot, a very healthy population of goosegrass with our characteristic growth habit of goosegrass, flattened sheaths, white center, clump type growth. You can see in this plot, we've got our Bermudagrass on one side, our goosegrass on the other. This is Sencor in Dismiss. Sencor is a photosystem II inhibitor. Dismiss is a PPO inhibitor. Sencor in this concept is going to be root absorbed. The PPO inhibitor Dismiss will be foliar absorbed. The idea is to kind of give Sencor a little bit of a kick for faster activity. This was sprayed over 3 weeks ago, so we can see that we don't really have any damage to our Bermudagrass here, and we've got a reduction in our goosegrass pressure. Next plot in the queue here is MSMA Sencor. This is a standard treatment in turfgrass for a long time. It's now been a little bit restricted with MSMA use being spot treatment only in many turfgrass scenarios. As you can see, our Bermudagrass is relatively uninjured from this. We did have some temporary yellowing after application, but that has really grown out and become transient after 3 weeks, and our goosegrass control is excellent. Next treatment here is another Sencor Dismiss mixture. We've got a Sencor rate here that's a little bit higher of 8 ounces, and then our 8 ounce rated Dismiss. Kind of our same story, that safe to our Bermudagrass, and we have reduced our goosegrass population significantly compared to our non-treated check. Next treatment here is a combination of Revolver, which is a goosegrass herbicide, an ALS inhibitor that's been used for a long time, with Dismiss. The concept here is Revolver as an ALS material is a little slow acting. Dismiss is faster acting as a PPO inhibitor. Could we put the two of these together and get maybe more rapid goosegrass control? We can see safety to our Bermudagrass here, and we've reduced our goosegrass population. We've got some remaining plants, but again, hopefully the slow activity or Revolver may take those down a little further. This is Revolver at the full label rate of 26.2 ounces per acre. That's the goosegrass control rate on the label. We can see very safe to our Bermudagrass turf, and it has effectively controlled our goosegrass compared to the non-treated. The next plot here, this is Sencor at 4 ounces. So this would be a low rate of Sencor for goosegrass control post-emergence. And we can see that reflected in the plot, right? We've got a lot of remaining goosegrass that's in there. We've got some crabgrass in there too. Again, that Sencor treatment, by and large in these trials, is focused on goosegrass and not crabgrass. At the 4 ounce rate, we have safety to our Bermudagrass. But again, probably not enough to do what we want from a control standpoint with a single application. Next plot you see here, this is MSMA alone, and this is going to be the full 2 pound AI rate of MSMA. Again, applied 3 weeks ago. Safe to our Bermudagrass. You know, any temporary yellowing that we would see with an MSMA application is long gone by 3 weeks after treatment. We've reduced our goosegrass population, but again, not perfect, could use a little bit of help, and that's where that MSMA Sencor mix really separates itself as an advantage. This treatment here has gained a lot of steam in this summer on social media. So this is 8 ounces of Sencor alone. You can see, safe to our Bermudagrass, it's reduced our goosegrass compared to the non-treated. Not perfect, right? We've got some straggling plants behind us, and this is, it's an interesting lead. We have a lot more to learn research-wise on this treatment. The concept with Sencor is that we're going to irrigate that application into the soil after we apply it to the turf. We want to apply enough irrigation to move it off the leaf tissue of the Bermudagrass and get it into the root zone of the goosegrass, but not too much irrigation such that we move it out of that root zone and it can't do what we want from a weed control standpoint. Obviously, that's going to vary on soil type. This is a sandy soil, so our irrigation load here may be very different than if we were to put this on a clay-based soil or even a silt loam soil at a different location. So we have more work to do to figure out what's the right amount of irrigation after a Sencor treatment to give us turf grass safety and weed control efficacy. Next treatment here, this is Revolver at 17.4 ounces per acre. This is a little bit of a lower rate than what we saw earlier on in this test. 17.4 is more of our annual bluegrass control rate with Revolver. But again, from an efficacy standpoint, we've controlled our goosegrass nicely, and then we have safety to our Bermudagrass, which is no surprise with Revolver being a labeled application. So this is Tribute Total at 3.2 ounces, which is the full label rate for a single application of Tribute. Safe to our Bermudagrass. Again, this is lagging behind a little bit from a control standpoint to the other treatments that we've seen in this test, but our safety to the Bermudagrass is what you would expect. This is Sencor at 6 ounces here in this last treatment. Similar story to what we've seen with Sencor at 8 ounces, that we have safety to our Bermudagrass, particularly when we irrigate after application to move it off the Bermudagrass leaf tissue and into the soil. We've got some stragglers left behind. Our efficacy here with this 6 ounce rate of Sencor is not what we would want. Some of that could be irrigation related, that on a sandy soil site, it would be very easy with post-application irrigation to move this below the portion of the root zone where it's going to be effective on goosegrass. So I think we have more to learn about how to optimize Sencor, but it is a lead for sure for post-emergence goosegrass control in Bermudagrass.